please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. Sources tell CNBC TV18 that bankers are evaluating 5 bids for Jaypee Infratech. Remember, the bids were opened yesterday. Ritu Singh, who has been giving us the heads up on all these deals before anyone else, is joining us on the phone line. Ritu, what have you picked up?
You know, just as you said, 5 bids is what Jaypee Infratech is currently, lenders for Jaypee Infratech are currently evaluating. These 5 players to begin with are JSW Group towards ARM JSW Infrastructure, Kotak Mahindra Bank in a joint venture with Cube Investments, a Chinese real estate company, and Suraksha ARC are among the highest bidders. Adani Group has also put in a bid, but that is significantly lower than the other 4 players. We understand that all of the 4 players have made sufficient bids to cover the home buyers' claims. That is, the bids are over 9,000 crore rupees each. Adani Group's bid is the only bid that is lower than 7,000 crore rupees. Remember, there were over 10-15 offers made for Jaypee Infratech, but a lot of those offers did not include the entire assets, but specific assets of the group, which is why lenders rejected all of those bids. Now, from the bids that have been opened so far and where only, not very fine details have been seen yet, JSW Infra's offer seems the better of the lot with a package of 9,914 crore rupees because it offers 6,000 crores of upfront cash payment to the lenders, and it has also offered to buy 1,000 acres of land for about 9,000 crore rupees from the lenders. Now, when you compare it to the offers from some of the other players, where, for instance, Kotak has asked for has offered about 9,000 crore rupees, but instead it has asked, instead of 1,000 acres, it has asked for 2,000 acres of land. In other cases, perhaps the instruments that they've offered are not very, acceptable to the lender. So JSW seems the better of the lot. But in this case, the drawback is that JSW has asked bankers to settle all dues, including those from the home buyers, the farmers' compensations on the land. So there will be some haircut that the banks will have to take. So therefore, there will be a meeting again soon to evaluate which of these offers to really go ahead with.
Okay, Ritu, thanks a lot for that. In fact, next up we have Prashant Jain, the joint MD and CEO of JSW Energy, who joins in to talk, of course, about the sector, but about a whole host of other issues as well. Mr. Jain, good morning and thanks for joining in. I just wanted your thoughts on this news flow that my colleague just spoke about, where JSW Infra has offered a huge package of almost 10,000 crores for Jaypee Infra.
Yeah, good morning. The bid has been made by JSW Infrastructure and I'm not privy to any of such development.
Okay, we thought since you were also in the infrastructure space broadly, you have some insight into it. Okay, well, Prashant, to get to the reason why we invited you, your plans for the EV space, I believe you have signed an MOU with a couple of states. Just give us some details on the money involved, the technology partners, and by when will this game start yielding you money?
Good morning, Lata. So JSW Energy decided to enter into electric vehicle space, and so with that aspiration, we have already signed MOU with Government of Gujarat and Government of Maharashtra. And as you know, that government is in the process of bringing out new EV policy. Recently, Government of Maharashtra has already announced it. So we are in discussion with both the governments to work on the modalities, and then we will be deciding that where we will be setting our facility. As regards to the project, our idea is to build a complete automotive company which will be with lot of models which will be for passenger car segment, and we are expecting that the first car will be launched in between 3 to 4 years time frame from now. And as we mentioned in our past conversation, that the board has proposed at this point of time to do the complete feasibility study, but we are estimating close to 4,000 crore rupees capital expenditure to start with.
Okay, and how much will go as equity from the listed JSW Energy?
So that is will be decided over a period of time as we complete our complete business plan. So it will be a mix of both equity and debt, which will be through a complete, because we have made a 100% subsidiary will be carrying out, and then equity will be funded from JSW Energy into the company.
And who will the technology partners be?
So we are at this point of time working with various technology partners, both in automotive segment as well as in battery segment. So we are in process of finalization. In due course, we will be informing.
Okay. Prashant, good morning. How's the traditional business doing in terms of average merchant rates, any new short-term or long-term PPA?
So good morning, Anuj. As regards to power business is growing pretty well. You know, after what we saw in last 5 years, the demand grew only 4% CAGR between 2012 to 2017. First time in the current financial year, we have seen the demand has picked up. In first quarter of the current financial year, we saw the demand grew 5.1%, which grew 5.7% in quarter two, and quarter three, 6.6%. So quarter on quarter, the demand is growing. And that is what is also reflecting in the higher PLF countrywide. And no new capacity addition is taking place. So that is what is also reflecting in the merchant prices. If you see the last whole year average, the merchant prices were 2.69 rupees, which has gone up to 3.19 rupees in the current financial year. So the oversupply situation is going to get bridged over a couple of quarters. So we are pretty much excited about that. So we see a lot of consolidation opportunities going forward.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to know generally how the business is. Are you expecting that you're going to see any further PPAs?
Yeah, so if you look at that, we started our long-term PPA portfolio with 64% on 1st of April in the current financial year. As we are speaking, we are close to 70% long-term PPA portfolio, and we are expecting to close this financial year by 74% portfolio. So precisely, if you see during the financial year, we have increased our portfolio by close to 11%. And that will further add up to another 10-11% in next financial year. So we are seeing that visibility. More and more short-term, medium-term PPAs are happening, and long-term okay. PPAs are happening. So going forward, this situation is going to converge.
So, we just spoke to the power secretary a couple of days back, and he was saying the industry PLF itself is kind of reaching 60. Yours is what, 58? When do you see that improving?
So our as I said, our long-term PPA portfolio is 70%. So 70% is totally tied up. So okay. Which is running with complete normative PLF,
okay.
And the balance 30%, which is running at this point of time, which is on merchant open capacity, there our PLF is close to 45%.
Okay.
And that we are seeing continuous improvement going forward.
Okay. Are you looking at acquiring any stressed assets, any of the NCLT cases? Because, both Bina and Tamnar were both shelved. But anything that you're looking at next?
Sure. Because that's what I mentioned, that I see a lot of consolidation in the sector, and there are a lot of stressed assets, and we are interested in most of the assets. So we are looking assets which are closer to mining areas, which are having partly fuel linkage or some partly power tie-up. And so we are pretty much interested in most of the assets which are stressed at this point of time.
So only, right?
With the new circular which has recently come, we feel that a lot of assets will come for consolidation.
Oh, yes, of course. You mean the new circular from the Reserve Bank, right? You expect that there will be large haircuts and you will have to assume much less debt in those? And will they all be thermal?
Right now the thermal assets are stressed at this point of time. We are seeing a lot of transactions in renewable space which are taking place, but that sector is not yet stressed. So in case of thermal assets, yes, the worms are out of can at this point of time. So there were a lot of assets which were under SDR or S4A or deep restructuring, where it was under the standstill, and based on the new reference rate, lenders will have to make provision, and then within 180 days it has to go to NCLT.
All right, Prashant, thanks a lot for your time today. Good talking to you. That's JSW Energy.
Good takeaway that they are interested in buying stressed power assets. Yes. There were not too many.
Yes, you know, since we are on the topic of power, I don't think we addressed this in our top 10. The news that we broke yesterday that power minister is going to meet Mundra power projects of Tata Power and Adani Power, because, you know, for long they've been calling for, you know, they've offered 51% equity
for one rupee.
For 1 rupee. I think that's going to be the next big trigger for these two stocks. And that's why, you know, today I think both these stocks right now are making highs of the morning, Tata Power and Adani Power as well, because this was the long-standing issue, which is something that the companies had been asking for. So since we were on that topic and the stocks were making highs of the morning, I thought I'll just revisit that topic. But anyway, let's move on. We have Ashwini Gujral, Mitesh Thakkar and Sandeep Bagle now joining us for some fresh trades at 10 a.m. Morning to you again. Ashwini, so, you know, we had a decent gap up and that's sustaining now. And in fact, building onto that, especially in the mid-cap side, your thoughts on how they could pan out and what would be your stocks?
See, the short covering move has started, but it is short covering. Nifty is hardly up 40 points. So that way, you know, you have to keep in mind and keep looking over your shoulder. But this could extend further, like I said earlier. So metals, PSU banks, private banks, everything participates, you know, once you are coming out of the sort of doldrums you are in. So that way, you know, the long trade should work for a while. As far as individual stocks are concerned, try to get into stuff that's been beaten up. So Tata Steel is a buy with a stop of 645, target of 670. Maruti is a buy with a stop of 8650, target 8900. And Hexaware is a buy with a stop of 348, target of 362.
Okay, just a couple of more stocks, Ashwini. A stock that has broken out of its two-year range now is Ipca Labs. It's hit a new high today. Any thoughts there? And even on Avenue Supermarts, that one is also surging this morning.
See, for me, Avenue Supermarts is a easier call to take, because, you know, Ipca Lab, etc., things go wrong without any warning. So Avenue Supermarts, big correction. You should go ahead and buy it. I think in terms of pharma, I've said earlier, I think Biocon is the only stock which kind of is giving you consistent patterns. Ipca, we'll see, you know, how the trend develops.
Okay, Mitesh Thakkar is also with us. Mitesh, morning again, your trades?
Yeah, so I think DMart or Avenue Supermart was in my list as well. I think it's moved up slightly, tried to buy it around 1260-64 and keep a stop at 1244 for targets of 1325. And I had a buy on Venkis, which unfortunately I think is very close to the target now. It's now 7.5% up, so we'll avoid that call. But this clearly is a stock which appears to have started a fresh trend, and the target on the upside should be closer to about 3,500 over here. So a good way would be to buy it around 3,100 with a stop below 3,000 for targets of 3,500.
Okay, actually I wanted to ask Ashwini, for that matter, what about Coal India? Is it not showing a significant or a steady pattern of higher highs?
Well, you know, the problem is that these things are not run generally on business concerns. So Coal India, ONGC, etc., they are great buys, you know, after a bear market. But to buy Coal India after it's up 35-40%, I don't think makes sense, because PSUs at higher levels, things go wrong. We've seen what happened with PSU banks. So you don't want to get into that sort of mess. Instead, be in a Motherson Sumi, which has corrected 25%, and even if it makes back to previous highs, you'll at least make 25%.
Okay. Ashwin, just one more chart check on Jindal Steel and Power. That stock is right now having a big run. In fact, just see the chart of that stock. And, you know, it gets into these kind of moves. at 258, what would be the call here?
See, today is a bit of a metals day, and this tends to have big longs and big shorts. So 240 is a stop here, and if the metals rally continues, maybe 285, 290 can come back on JSPL.
Okay. Sandeep Bagle is also here with us in the studio. Sandeep, hi, morning. What are you looking at? The big stock moving from the frontliners now is Sun Pharma. Almost a 5% up move on Sun Pharma this morning. But anything you're looking at?
Good morning, Sonia. A little late, I would say. But yes, some more upside. I would talk of a buy in a Cholamandalam Finance, stop loss of 1399, target 1487. And a sell in a Siemens, which has given a breakdown. Stop loss of 1185, target 1134.
Oh yes, so many people are selling Siemens. Well, Ashmi, Ashok Leyland?
See, again, Ashok Leyland is an outperformer. So if you buy here, we should get maybe 150, 155. You know, I think autos have been beaten up quite a bit. So Maruti could also have a 3 to 5 day type of rally. So Ashok Leyland, Escorts, they haven't broken their trends. So the strongest auto stocks are these two auto stocks.
Okay, and Ashwini, you were just discussing power stocks. Both Adani Power and Tata Power now moving to high point on news. Anything here?
See, again, you know, these are not stocks which make, give you multi-baggers or which have large moves. I think mid-cap IT continues to do well, Mindtree, etc. And that's where, you know, the big money will get made. So it's kind of avoidable, these power stocks, because a couple of days from now, they'll lose their way.